oriental embroidery site. It is a lace color design. And this one I embroidered by combining splitted parts because I have a 5-7 hoop, and because of that I had to ask the oriental embroidery site to split the designs. This design I want to use for a project, and I wanted to have colors. How to, in an easy way, create a colored lace design. I use silk paints, and this one is called Yavana, but you can use any sort of silk paint, but you must use the one, because that is the most easy way, and it fastens completely to the fibers, and even if you wash it 10 times or 20 times, it will still stick in the fibers. But you must use the colors to be fixed by ironing. You don't have to use the colors having to be steamed to fasten to the fibers, because that is too much work for a tiny part like this. I start by covering the table with plastic, and then I spray water onto the whole design so it gets completely damp. If I don't, it will steal too much color. In fact, you use less color doing it this way. Then, I think it's enough. So what you need is some brushes, different sizes, and a water container. That is important. When you paint, do seal painting with the water-based seal paints, water is the most important ingredient you use, because you can in fact simply by putting water onto the color, the color changes completely. So I will start. The colors I want to use on this one is a tiny bit of blue. I will use green, dark red, and a tiny bit of pink, and yellow. So I will start using the green. Water onto the brush, and then I don't know if you can see it completely, but you can see here, I'm using a lot of water. You see the color comes immediately to, you don't have to brush. It is drawn into the fibers, in fact. So seal paint is a wonderful paint to use on textile. And another reason for using seal paint and not ordinary textile paint, or fabric paint, as it's called, is because ordinary fabric textile paint, it's opaque, and it fastens outside the fibers in a way. But silk paint is drawn into the fibers, and when it is finished, it looks as if you have in fact embroidered with those colors. This part will look as if I have embroidered it in a sort of variegated green thread. That's the main reason for using silk paint for coloring lace. So I will do all these curly parts in green, and it's not, you see, when you use silk paint, you can mix and mix and mix. So in this green you can, I think I will show you after when I come to the other color. You can use pink, some pink into this green part, and suddenly you have a most artistic artistic design. You may have to spray a little more water onto my working because it dries out. And as I told you, water is the most important ingredient. This is just the start, you know, because it may look completely different when I'm finished. Suddenly this part might even be red when I'm finished. I don't know yet, because as I go on, I find new ways of decorating it. And that's a wonderful thing with silk paint. You can change it many ways on the way. Okay. Green. Red, dark red that is. Can you see how easy it's done? You can in fact just brush it all over the part, the whole part someplace. Because, and if you think your colors are too strong, you can just take the water spray bottle and spray water onto it, and suddenly the color is more light. It is not as dark as it was before.